My name is Mort Chatterjee. On behalf of G5A Foundation for Contemporary Culture and Chatterjee and Lal, I would like to welcome you to another session of Should Art 2020, an art and culture festival celebrating 5 years of G5A. Over the past 5 years, G5A has worked with the belief that art and culture have the power to catalyze change for the better by challenging people to think critically, creatively, and courageously. They have been firmly asserting the importance and necessity of the arts in our lives and the role it should play. And now it is even more critical. Over these 5 years, they have built a community, an ecosystem that believes in the possibility of new, unfiltered voices and the possibility of building communities that are equitable, inclusive, and just. Should Art 2020 brings together artists from across disciplines to celebrate through a series of diverse dialogues, performances, and exhibitions as they continue to nurture a vibrant, safe, and inclusive platform that encourages the creative and just in thought and expression. In doing so, their endeavor is to enrich people's lives, rebuild resilient and responsible communities, and strengthen the cultural fabric of our community and city. Hi, my name is Mort Chatterjee. I'm one half of Chatterjee and Lal. We're a gallery based in Bombay working with contemporary and historical material. And I'd like to thank G5A for the invitation to speak today on the occasion of their 5th year anniversary celebrations. Congratulations to G5A, the whole team there for this on this important milestone. And the challenge that they set me was to speak about one individual artwork, which of course poses its own problems because we're not talking about an entire artistic career or even a body of work, but just one individual object. But I'm excited for the challenge. And the painting that I'd like to speak about is by the artist Nityan Unnikrishnan. Nityan was born in 1976 in Kerala, and after studying at the National Institute of Design in Gujarat, he has variously lived in Delhi and more recently in Goa. We've been showing Nityan's work now for the last 10 years, and this work is from an upcoming solo exhibition we have planned for mid-November. The exhibition is called It Is Getting Louder, and the work is called The House Tilts. It's an acrylic. It's one of six in the exhibition, which will be displayed alongside a group of works on paper. For our last exhibition with Nityan, we had invited Ruchi Joshi to write an essay, and in that wonderful piece, he created a mental image of Nityan in a train compartment alongside the artists Sudhir Patwardhan and Bhupen Kakkar. In other words, to say that Nityan is a fellow traveller with those two artists. And despite the fact that Patwardhan and Kakkar are significantly more senior and older than Nityan, I do believe that there are ways in which certainly you can see affinities, both in terms of their interest in specific narrative structures, and also in terms of their painterly instincts. In terms of the way all three build up their paintings, I think there's a joint interest in the idea of the quotidian, the everyday, in terms of the common man, but the way in which those stories of the everyday give way to broader political, social issues of concern to everyone in the nation state. In this particular work, The House Tilts, we're presented ostensibly with a bedroom, and within that bedroom are protagonists, one asleep, one with their back turned to us, perhaps just on the point of waking up. The figure asleep has been painted meticulously, the brushstrokes fine. The figure seated, back turned to us, has a heavy, almost clumpish feel to them, and their gender is unclear. So it's around these two protagonists that the painterly world emerges. And Nityan has used here a device that he's becoming more and more excited by and has been using over the last, I'd say, 3 to 4 years, and that is the view within the view, the painting within the painting. So in the upper left quadrant, we have perhaps a window, a view out of a window, or perhaps it's a large-scale painting, slightly unclear. And what we look onto is this dystopian vista. It's a landscape populated by these chimeric hybrid creatures, reminding us perhaps of the creatures which inhabit the works of Hieronymus Bosch, and in his famous The Garden of Earthly Delights. And these creatures cavort, prod, violate each other, whilst around them you see these abstract, sculptural, perhaps monumental forms. If sculptural, one's reminded of surrealist sculptures from the early to mid-20th century. If monuments, certainly one is thinking of present-day India and the overpopulation in urban spaces of monuments to politicians. Either way, these creatures, these sculptural monumental forms, present, as I said earlier, this dystopic view, and certainly in stark contrast to the relative safety and splendid isolation of our protagonists in the bedroom. I just point out this duvet, which almost has this watery, oceanic-like feel. There's something quite tactile about the way that it moves, it ripples almost, and the way that the characters float on its surface. Around them, of course, you see the bedside tables, a pair of shoes in a box, and this rug, which seems to have some affinities with mid-20th century abstract painting. The next view within a view is up here on the right, and that is a painting hanging on the wall. And in that painting, one sees a man and a woman, both seated but separate in their own worlds, and they seem to mirror in some way our two protagonists here, where the protagonists, of course, are involved in sleep and the practice of sleep, or the practice of emerging from a dream state. Our two characters in the painting are invested in the everyday world of thought, of work itself. So the relationship then between the characters on the bed, the outside world, the painting on the wall, all of these are cues, provocations, which Nityan sets up for the viewer. And of course, the way he does it, and I think the way that I've tried to hint at, is not to create a closed conversation. There's no right or wrong way of understanding the painting. Instead, he seems to build up many resonances, many open conversations. It was the idea of K.G. Subramanian, the artist and art critic, to suggest that the more resonances a painting provides, the better that painting is. His thought process coming out of the idea of linguistics and literature, and the idea that narrative structures are a potent way of presenting art to viewers, coming from the school of E.H. Gombrich and others. And certainly in the case of Nityan's work here, and I think in all his work, it's this idea of open-ended conversation that I find most tantalizing, and certainly I think also loyal collectors of his. His paintings reveal themselves slowly. They don't give of themselves easily. And so they're joys to live with, because one can tease out different meanings at different times. And I think certainly that's because Nityan himself has embedded so many reference points, but also he allows the reader the viewer, I'm sorry, to come to the works at different moments in their own lives. And drawing again a comparison with another artist, I think K.G. Subramanian himself is an artist who we could certainly talk about in the same breath as Nityan, in so far as they both share this interest in storytelling, narrative structures, but very open-ended in their nature. Interestingly, of course, K.G. Subramanian, like Nityan, was born and was raised in Kerala, and both, funny enough, also come from households steeped in rationalist philosophies. And yet Kerala, as we all know, has in its very DNA a rich history of folklore and storytelling. And I think it is the tension between the rationalist and the folkloric that plays out in both artists' careers. And in fact, it's for that reason that I would have K.G. Subramanian as an honoured third senior artist, along with Nityan, in that illusionary train compartment that I was referring to earlier. So for me, The House Tilts is an extraordinary painting, and one that I think will give of itself for many years for viewers. I do hope that you have enjoyed having a look at it. I also hope that you'll get to see the rest of the exhibition either online or, if you're brave enough, in person. And I'd like to thank G5A again for giving me the opportunity to talk about one of my favourite artists and one of his brand new works. Thank you so much, and I hope that we meet each other again soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.